Hi everyone, so today we will be learning English. Before that, let me introduce myself. My name is Miss Sally. So, today's topic is about our green earth. Here, you will be asking to give your opinion after the end of the session. First of all, I will show you a video. Please enjoy! So what do you think? Based on the video, what is it about? Based on the video, it is about environmental issues. So now we will be learning about definition, causes, effects, and solutions about environmental issues. So before that, we have to know what are environmental issues. Environmental issues are human activities that negatively impact the environment. So now, after we know the definition of environmental issue, the next question is, when did environmental issues start? Environmental issues started 500,000 years ago. Next, where do we find environmental issues? We can find it everywhere around the world. Who are affected by environmental issues? Environmental issues affect animals, water, air, plants, and even humans. Why is it important to understand environmental issues? It is important because we live in the environment that provides us with water, air, plants, animals that we need to survive. Therefore, we need to protect the environment. Now, the next question is how to protect the environment? To protect the environment, we need to 1. Don't litter. 2. Don't smoke. 3. Don't waste electricity. 4. Don't waste water. 5. Don't waste food. Remember 3 R. They are reuse, reduce, and recycle. Now, let's think. Please give me your opinion about, is coronavirus an environmental issue? After we know about the question, so now we are going to have activity, which is giving opinion. Please give me your opinion where you complete this task by talking or pronounce about your answer. For example, is coronavirus an environmental issue? My opinion is, I think coronavirus is an environmental issue because, so you have to give me your own opinion. So your speaking will be assessed by speaking rubric. There are 4 components here, which are content, eye contact, fluency, volume, expression, and clarity. If you want to get higher score, means that you have to pay attention at 3 points here. The content 1. If your speech contains some of the contents, means that you will just only get 1 point. If your speech contains most of the contents, means that you will get 2 points. But if your speech contains all the contents, means that you will get higher score, get higher point, which is 3. And then the next component is eye contact. If you didn't look at the camera, means that you will get 1 point, because if you don't look at the camera, means that you were not confident. If most of the time you look at the camera, means that you will get 2 points. And if you look at the camera all the time, means that you are confident when you are speaking, means that you will get highest points here, which is 3. And then the next component is fluency. If your speech was slow, hesitant, and difficult to perceive continuity, means that you will get 1 point. If your speech was frequently hesitant, a slight search for words, means that you will get 2 points. If your speech was smooth, fluid speech, no hesitation, no attempts to search for words, means that you will get highest points here, which is 3. And then the last component is volume, expression, and clarity. If you didn't use appropriate language, clear pronunciation, and didn't consistently change tone of voice to engage people like this, Hi everyone, my name is blah, blah, blah. So my opinion is, so the intonation, there is no intonation, there is no clear pronunciation, means that you will get 1 point. If most of the time you use appropriate language, clear pronunciation, and consistently change tone of voice to engage people, means that you will get 2 points. And then the last one, if you always use appropriate language, clear pronunciation, and consistently change tone of voice to engage people like this. Hi everyone, so my opinion is coronavirus is an environmental issue because you will get the highest point, which is 3. So, good luck with your task. If you have any question, don't hesitate to write to me an email. It is Sally, sally.wijaya29@gmail.com. I will see you again in the next video. So, bye-bye.